Amy, is this the most important part of flyball?
Yeah, this is where races are won or lost.
Absolute racing perfection.
Ideally, you want the dogs passing nose to nose on this line.
Ah, so if we are so close in the changeover that the incoming dog crosses the line before the outgoing dog has left, fault.
Yeah, fault, and you'll have to rerun. You want your dog reaching its maximum speed as it comes through this gate here.
Ah, is that what these are here?
Yeah, so these are what these markers are for. So you can get really exact measurements of where you let your dog go.
Another thing I've noticed as well are those lights. Can you talk us through those?
Yeah, so you've got your start sequence, your amber, 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 green.
Away we go, it's a flying start.
And then these lights on the side, so your red, blue, amber and green, they signal which dog has faltered.
And a fault on the near side as well. This is pandemonium up here.
Logic would dictate to me that you put your fastest dog last. Would you do that?
Not necessarily, no. I think it's about four dogs and handlers working together. You could have a really fast dog, but if that handler can't do changeovers, that can determine a win or a loss in a race.
This is going to be really good. Oh. Well, how close was that?